Hi, welcome to How to Repair. This video is on a washing machine that is not spinning or turning. It's manufactured by Beko, but can be used for all the brands listed below. Right, the first thing we're going to do is turn the machine onto a spin cycle and see if we've got any motor action at all. Sometimes you will end up with an error code appearing on the front of the machine, which will tell you that you have a motor fault, but on other occasions it just stops working. Now you can hear the pump running on this machine, but we have no sound from the motor and the drum's not rotating. Now if you could hear the motor trying to spin and the drum was not turning, then there is a possibility that it was a fault with the belt. In other words, the belt may have come off. But one of the first checks you want to do is empty the actual filter to make sure there is no debris in the pump. On most modern washing machines, they will never go into spin if there is water still in the drum. It's a protection system to actually stop the machine spinning with water in it. As you can well imagine the mess it would make if you tried to spin the clothes with a full load of water in there. So if your clothes are coming out wringing wet and there's still a bit of water in the drum, it might not be a motor fault. It might be just a simple blockage in the system. This can either be on the pump area, and sometimes this can be on where the waste hose is fitted. Some people have their waste hoses attached to the sink units, and this can also be a common problem. But we know this is all clear, so we're going to remove the back of the machine and we're going to take the motor off to inspect it. The first thing you should do is disconnect the appliance from the electricity supply. While I'm taking this motor off, there are links on the left-hand side of the video, and these will take you through to the correct tutorial area or the correct part you need. For mobile users, you will find this in the description below the video. The top link is to the carbon brushes for Beko washing machines. You will need your full model number to obtain the correct parts. You will find this inside your door area or sometimes on the back of the machine. The two links at the bottom left-hand side, which are tutorials and FAQs, will take you through to the Beko washing machine section where all the tutorials for the repairs can be found, and you can get detailed information on error codes and self-diagnostic mode of these machines. And please remember to subscribe to our channel, whether it's YouTube or Facebook or Google+, as that's what keeps us going and able to make these free videos for you. And if we do save you lots of money on these repairs, please remember you can always buy me a beer using the Buy Me a Beer button. Right, now we've actually got the motor front bolts released, we're just going to do the back ones. Now, I can't emphasize enough here, having the right tools for the job do help. This extension bar, which is also flexible, does allow me to get through from the back of the machine to the back bolts. If you haven't got one of these and you've only got a torque spanner, then you're going to have to tilt the machine over at a 45 degree angle and do it manually, which will take quite a bit of time as they're tucked in right against the drum. Now that all the bolts have been removed, we need to prise the motor slightly backwards just to get it loose on the lugs before removing. Now, of course, you're working in your house, so you don't have the joy of a test bench, so you will need to lean the machine over at a 45 degree angle to remove the motor. Now, there's four screws holding these carbon brushes in place, but the first thing I want to explain to you is a bit about the carbon brushes themselves. Carbon brushes are sliding contacts used to transmit an electrical current from a static to a rotating part in the motor called a commutator. The main reason for the angle is good surface area and allow the carbon brush to work without overheating. This is why they're fitted at a slight angle. A commutator has segments you can see here. You need to inspect the commutator for any raised lugs. In other words, if one of these are higher than the other, then it would chew away at the brushes and create excess wear. I will show you this later in the video. But the first thing we need to do is remove the carbon brushes from the motor. Beko actually fitted a couple of different types of carbon brush to the motors. I will explain the difference on the holders, but it's a good idea to always have your full model number and check against the brushes that your model number is listed before ordering, as they have fitted a couple of types. But you can see this carbon brush was completely worn away. And here's the new one. Now, when they're delivered, they come like this in their holder. And people do not realize that they have a transit clip, which you need to prise up. And once you've prised it up, you need to make sure that the carbon brush goes in and out freely before fitting the carbon brush. Otherwise, you will have a problem. But you can see the difference between the old and the new. The old's completely worn away. And this wasn't the bad carbon. This is actually the carbon that's still got a little bit of life left in it. Now, the difference between the two types of holders that they fitted is the lugs. Now, the one on the right-hand side, which I've already loaded in because I didn't have the right ones in stock to show you on this video, but the only difference is the actual locating lugs. The actual inner part of the brush, the metal casing and the brush itself, are usually the same, and you can swap holders if you do order the wrong ones ever. From wherever you order them, you can actually split the brush casing and then swap over the brushes. But the most important thing is, as I explained earlier, to make sure you get the direction of the slant correctly onto the armature. So in other words, it fits onto the commutator nice and evenly and flat, not the high point hitting the commutator first. So we'll just replace this carbon brush and then I'll do the other one for you. Do remember, at the website we have loads of videos on Beko washing machines, on how to change your door seal, pump, heaters and diagnostic videos. Also, we have all the error codes for you at the website. So just remember to go to the website if you ever have a problem, and we should be able to point you in the right direction. There's also a live chat on the website if you do need technical assistance. I will help where I can. Now here you can see the really worn down carbon brush. It's black on the tip. This means that it has been burning against the armature. This can do damage to the commutator itself, and if left too long, you could also possibly do damage to the circuit board. But you can see here the difference between the mounting lugs, the original one to the left has got two lugs next to the screw holes, and the one to the right, it's the one I'm swapping over, has two lugs in the middle of the holder. So just undo the clip when they arrive, the brush will pop out. And as I said earlier, do make sure that they slide in and out of the holder freely. And you can see the difference in the wear length. And again, the mounting lugs on the original are side by side, and the other ones are in the middle of the brush holder. So we'll just swap the casings over on these, and then fit them. Now, while I'm fitting the new carbon brush, I'll just make you aware that you want to inspect the commutator for any raised lugs after, or you should do it really before fitting the new brushes. But once you've got the new brushes fitted, do have a check around your commutator and make sure that there's no burred edges. Because the one carbon was badly burnt, it can cause hot spots on the segments in the commutator and burn the edges of them. So I will show you a technique for cleaning these up in a second. Just connect the wires up first. While I'm doing this, if you ever need to test a motor outside of the parameters of the washing machine, in other words, making a test rig, there is a video on this at the website. but you do need to be electrically minded to understand how the fields work. So I'm just checking the commutator there. Now this is a commutator stick that we use in the trade, and it's basically sandpaper with rubber mixed, and we just rest it against the commutator while rotating, and it basically just cleans up the commutator for fitting new brushes. But I'm showing you, you can use a piece of wet and dry sandpaper. I would use no coarser than 800. So in other words, 800 to 1200 is fantastic. I wouldn't use anything coarser than 800 for this job, as it's too abrasive and will damage the armature. So just a piece of wet and dry does a nice job on it. And make sure you do it evenly. Right, now we'll just fit the motor and then we'll put it on test. So again, just from underneath, put the motor onto the lugs, make sure you get the front and the back on, and then do up the bolts. While I'm doing this, as I said earlier, please remember to subscribe to our channel, whether it be on Facebook or YouTube or Google Plus, as that's what keeps us going and able to make these free videos for you. And again, if you do find this video helpful, you can always click on the donate button, which is buy Paul a beer, or buy me a beer. Now, when fitting the motor cable, do remember to get yourself a cable tie and actually put the wiring harness back on through here, as this will stop any metal fatigue within the wiring, so it's not moving all around, doesn't get caught on the belt or anything else. It just keeps it all neatly tucked away, and then cut it off after. And there we go. Now, when fitting a new belt, this is quite important. You've got to get the belt onto the motor spline first, put it about halfway round the pulley wheel, and then be careful with your fingers, but just use the larger wheel as a sort of leverage to get it onto the motor. And then once you've fitted it, don't just assume it's on there. Do make sure it lines up in the middle of the larger pulley. Sometimes you need to either move it forwards or backwards to make sure it lines up perfectly. Now we'll plug the machine in, and there we go. I won't wait for you to see the motor on spin. I'll just cut the video and then advance it. And there you go, the machine on full spin. Do remember to support the website by buying your parts, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, Facebook and Google+. And remember, if you did save a load of money on repairs by watching this video, you can always donate by buying us a beer. And remember, at the website there are hundreds more tutorials on cookers, tumble dryers, fridge freezers, etc. Thanks very much indeed for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video.